Hey everyone, so we're not reacting to a TV show or a movie today. I realize I've only just done TV shows as I'm saying that. Today is October 30th, aka the day before Halloween. Halloween is one of my favorite holidays because you get to dress up and have fun. This year's a bit different, but either way, I dress up. I'm going all out this year. I'm trying to do Midsummer. And Alexis Rose. I just finished Schitt's Creek. If you have not watched that show, go watch it now. It is the best thing ever. Loved it. Cry my eyes out. Watched it in a week and a half. Highly recommend it. So, we're here the next day. I have not heard the album. That's right. We are listening to Positions by Ariana Grande, which, I mean, this woman has fed us with so much music over the past 2.5 years. And I read Twitter last night. Everyone keeps saying this is the best album. So I have high expectations. Because Thank You Next is literally one of my favorite albums of all time. I will replay that. Like, there's not a song on there I don't like. So we're going to listen to the album. I'm so excited. So let's get into it. First song on the album is Shut Up. Violin, like, my presence sweet and my aura bright. Time is good for my appetite. Guess if I could just click one night. I'm sorry, that seemed like it was gonna be like some slow intro and then it's like da 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 da. Oh my gosh. Not what I was expecting. Okay, hold on. Oh, going down. Oh, outro. Sounds like I Love Lucy kind of type of 1950s sitcom vibes. For this one, out of 10, I would give this a 7. It's not my favorite. I mean, it's very different. It's just like, I don't see myself playing it as often already, but I love, like, the runs and, like, the message to it. So let's go to the next one, which would be Obvious. Okay, so I realized halfway through this that I was on shuffle, not listening in order. Oh, this is R&B, Anna. This is R&B. This is what I was looking forward to. This lighting change. Okay, let's continue with Obvious. She's so happy, she sounds like. Okay, Obvious. I absolutely love that. I give that a 9 out of 10. Like, that's what I was expecting from this album. So, I'm ready for more of that. 6:30. Heard a lot. This is giving me, like, Sweetener vibes a bit. Like, this gives me, I'm sorry. I'm gonna go there. But this song gives me, like, Pete Davidson vibes. Universe must have my back, fell from the sky into my love. And it's same kind of, like, beat, kind of, and melody with that. I was like, okay, I like it though, because I love that song. Yeah, okay, so for that one, I, like, again, I like it. I would probably give it, like, a 7 out of 10 as well. It does give me that kind of Sweetener vibes to, like, the instruments in the back and, like, kind of that violin chill vibe, which is a lot of Sweetener. Sweetener wasn't my favorite. There's a lot of great songs on that album. Wasn't fully my favorite. So I think this album for me is gonna be a lot like Sweetener. Like, I love a ton of songs on that album, but there's like a handful that are like not for me. Okay, we Just Like Magic. I haven't heard much about this, so let's see. Hold on, have I woken up in an 80s pop? That just sounds like the beginning of like an 80s pop commercial, like da, da, da. Just that one part. What? I just got chills. This feels like a teen dream and I love it. I love it. It's probably gonna be so different though. So for that one, I give that a 9 out of 10 because I love it, and I feel like I'm gonna give everything a 9 out of 10 right now if it's really good, because I'm waiting. I feel like there's something bigger coming that I'm gonna love. But I love that, and I will be playing that. I love that so much. So we're gonna go back. Let's go to 34, 35. The left. She ain't holding nothing back at this point. My innocence. Oh my god. Like the beat. I don't know what to rate it, really. Motive. This is Doja Cat and her. Ooh. People been teasing this. I am ready to hear this. Sounds like something that I play in like a roller rink, like da, 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 like 70s vibes here. Oh! Okay! Ten out of ten. Love that. We'll play that on repeat. Love, love, love that. We heard Just Like Magic. Off the Table. This is The Weeknd. These voices together, which we have heard before. What are you giving us again? Oh, we're dark. Okay. Ooh! Okay, I just kind of like just sat there enjoying because I like the mood of this song. 9 out of 10. Like, ooh. Just, ooh. Love it. Love it. Okay. 6:30, we already listened to Safety with Ty Dolla $ign. I already love this. Oh, yes! Boy, it must be something that you say. Oh, yes! You didn't always live in my head. Out of 10 yet again with this one. I love this so much. The vocals and ooh, how the she worked in Ty Dolla $ign. I love that. Was oh my gosh. And ooh, okay, my hair. This and Nasty is what was teased a lot, and that was like on pages and all that. So ooh, very 50s again, this kind of vibe. I mean, we talk about R&B. Oh my god, that. Oh my god. Oh, okay. Hold, give me, wait a damn minute. Okay. Oh, she went deep, scared. Oh, this is so R&B. The talent. She giving us rage in this song! She just did that entire last chorus in whistle tones. The talent! The vocal range in this song! Oh my god! Oh my god! 11 out of 10, bitch! That is it! Okay, now we got Nasty, so this is the one that was teased the most. Okay. Why does it sound like the wind up to the way? Oh my god. That sounds like the way that whistle note. Okay. Nine out of ten. Because I heard a bit of it. And it okay. I love that though. That kind of melody, not my favorite, but I feel like it'll grow on me. See, that's what I think, like, from, even from Sweetener, there's songs that I'm like, I wasn't like, oh, obsessed with at first. But the more I listened, I became obsessed. So we're gonna go to West Side now. If you turn the world up, meet me on the West Side, burn me harder. Sorry, I zoned out. I like that one. It's another one I think that's gonna, like, it's, I'll play it. I'm gonna say 8 out of 10. Because I like, it's just, like, really solemn and just kind of, like, ooh, like, chill. As soon as this just started. Love it. Okay. Love Language. And then after this, we have POV, because we've already listened to Positions and we've already listened to Obvious. Okay, Love Language sounds like the beginning of a 70s Saturday Night Fever here. Successful vibes. A G in your face. Yes, she is. Whoa, whoa. The whole song basically ended, and this is a whole nother part. What is this? What is this? Love Language? 10 out of 10. That ending's kind of weird, though. Gonna go into POV. This is a ballad, but a little sad-y. It's like you got superpowers. Turn my minutes into hours. You got another 2020 day. I had high expectations for that song and it fulfilled it. That is my favorite song off this album. Just, it's so sweet. And just... What? Yes, I know! Early voting! Go vote! If you live in the US, please. Please. I don't know, this song makes you feel good. Overall review of the album, okay. I think it's a 9 out of 10 for me. Because it's kind of like Sweetener, where Sweetener has a lot of songs that I like and a handful that I don't and won't play. The songs I like on this, oh, dang. Love it. I'm so excited for my November playlist. Ooh, I've been listening to Julie and the Phantoms. Good lord, if you have not seen that show. I get this on my playlist. I'm so happy for November. We're going into December. You know, Ariana saved 2020. Is that a correct statement? I think so. I loved reacting to that. Now I gotta work on my Halloween costume. But if you like this, please like and subscribe. Hopefully come out with some more stuff. I'm busy doing some movie making for school. Everybody stay safe. Go vote.